Kidzapo Valley National Park is one of the top five destinations in Africa, and it boasts of being home to the largest number of lions here in Uganda. And did you know that in Kidzapo is where you can find the real Lion King? I am Ruth Naseje, and it is always a pleasure to present this on New Vision TV's Pearl of Africa Diaries, your home of adventures.
Oh my God, can we get it?
The lions are found in each and every national park of Uganda. These animals portray fierceness. Even kings of Buganda are referred to as Empologoma, which is a Luganda word to mean a lion. In Kiswahili language, lions are called Simba. This king of the jungle takes credit for protecting its subjects in the wilderness. That is why the king above all kings is found right here at Kidzapo Valley National Park.
I think it's too full. Check.
While on those game drives in the park, lions can be spotted, especially in the morning. Their sociability with other animals in this park clearly shows a behavior of a real king. Take a look at this.
Area at night time you find it is cold, and that is why the meat has remained still fresh for some time.
Oh my God.
It is never advisable for a human being to get closer to a lion because they are indeed very dangerous animals. However, if you want to get closer to them, here at the Uganda Wildlife Education Center, an opportunity is opened for you. In this lion exhibit, five African lions are reserved, though at the time somewhere away. Dan Mirembe, a zookeeper, says there are four lionesses and one lion. Maintaining a lion under captivity is rather expensive, especially when it comes to feeding.
We normally feed them on beef, and each one of them, the lionesses, will give them 5 kilos of beef, and the male will give it 8 to 10 kilos. But what you have to have in mind is that in the wild, on average, the male eats 40 kilos per meal, on average. And the lioness, that's the female, eats an average of 15 kilos per meal. So, but after they have eaten that food, that estimation of meat, they can take like 2 days without eating.
These carnivorous animals prey on many animals, including zebras, buffaloes, and giraffes, and not forgetting hyenas. When they attack, their rough tongues make it easy to eat their prey by separating the skin from the flesh. Their hunt for prey is done by females, whereas males act as protectors. When they are not hunting, lions spend 16 to 20 hours of the day sleeping or resting. They lie on their backs with their feet up or making a doze up in the tree. While lazing around, they are very affectionate towards each other. They rub each other's heads, groom around, and also purr. Lions live in groups called prides. There may be two or three males in a pride, with one being the most dominant. The dominant male will mate with several females at around the same time. This ensures that new cubs will be about the same age, so some females can stay and watch over the cubs while others go out hunting. The gestation period of a female lion is about 105 to 110 days. The lioness will have a litter of about 2 to 4 cubs. No matter where the lions are, whether under captivity or in the wild, they fall sick. But how do the zookeepers know that any of the lions here is sick?
The response towards food. So usually, just as I told you, we normally feed them on 5 kilos of beef every day, with the exception of Mondays and Fridays. So you get to know if the food, if they have not responded well to the food. 2, the daily movements the daily movements. So you as a keeper or as a caretaker, you'll keep observing them. And if you get to know that the lion has spent almost the entire day in one place, then you get to know there's something that has gone amiss with it. So we don't just keep on putting them inside. We don't keep on looking at them, monitoring them, and recording their movements. So that's how you can tell. And then also you can also tell from the body condition. For example, if the temperatures are not good for it, you see the hair raising up most of the time. Even when the sun and others, when the hair is in good condition, but the one which is sick, you see the hair raising up, and that one will call immediately for veterinary attention.
The lions are the most dominating predators. That is why they are called the kings of the jungle. And this dominancy is also threatened by a few animals. These include the tallest animal, which is the giraffe, the ostriches, which have sharp pointed tools. They use these as their defensive mechanism. Humans are also a great threat to the lions.
The previous census that was carried out, we have an average of 420 lions in the entire nation. And Uganda has around 10 national parks. So that number is a very small number. And most of the national parks that we have, their neighbors, they're herdsmen. So sometimes when they go in for hunting and they don't see the wild animals, what they normally opt for is to go in the neighborhood, go and hunt for cattle, goat, and the sheep. And as a matter of fact, so what the herdsmen do is to poison them. So on average, we normally lose around 7 lions on average. So they are, according to their conservation status, as per IUCN, International Union of Conservation of Nature, they are classified to be some of the animals which are endangered.
However, the life expectancy of a lion is 12 years. In all the various national parks here in Uganda, trust me, you can find a lion. Some of our national parks include Kidepo Valley National Park, Queen Elizabeth National Park, Makshin Falls National Park, to mention but a few.
So this guy got stuck in the mud, you think?
Yeah, I think he got stuck in the mud and then it became an easy prey for the lions.
Finally is the scientific classification of a lion. The kingdom is Animalia, Phylum Chordata, Order Mammalia, Class Carnivora, Family Felidae, Genus Panthera, Species Leo. Uganda is home to so many animals, be it wild or domestic. I will keep profiling them here for you on New Vision TV's Pearl of Africa Diaries. But if you're interested in a particular animal, drop a comment below. We are your home of adventures, and I am Ruthie Naseje, your Pearl Guide.